I will introduce myself. My name is Frans Nestor. I'm sales and marketing manager for the company Technotic. Mm-hmm. And Technotic is a wholesale company that has two bodies, say so. One part mainly in the marina business.
Yeah. Yachts,
well, Frans, sorry to interrupt, but we have we have participants coming in,
okay.
And I think they have a fish, so we continue after.
Good, fish is most important thing.
I see they unhooking a Zender.
Yes.
Hello, guys. Yes. Can you turn the camera? A quarter to the left. Yes, perfect.
Nice. Nice little Zender. I'm not sure yet how long fish is, but I think like 60 or something. 65 centimeters. So we're gonna make a picture.
Yeah.
And we're gonna send them in the app.
Yes, perfect, guys.
Okay, thank you.
Happy hunting.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye. Okay, and we go back live to Frans. Sorry, Frans. You're on air again.
Good to be back. Not bad. More fish, the better. More fish, the better, yes. I was right in the middle of introducing the Technotic company. And Technotic is, like I said before, is a company with two different areas we work in. One is the marina business, and we sell everything on the boat except the boat itself,
from the tiny bits to the large sonar, huge anchors,
to heating systems, radars, whatever you can think of, lightings, toilets, pumps, whatever.
As a wholesale, and then and the retailers are all over Holland or all over Europe.
Well, we mainly do the Benelux,
yeah.
And a lot of our brands that we sell have their own distributors in different countries.
Mm-hmm.
So we have a the distribution for the Benelux,
yeah.
And for some brands we do. We also have a another company, TFB, in Germany that sell the same stuff. But we mainly focus on the Benelux. And the other leg of the company is the fishing tackle business, as we say. And in the fishing tackle, we don't sell rods, we don't sell lures, we leave that up to Evert.
Mm-hmm. We tried.
Okay, sorry Frans again, sorry, I have to cut you off again. We have a fisherman coming in now.
Good.
Hey guys, it's us, Joris and Johan, Team 35. We've got one mic, we lost four of them already. One bird already.
We keep on hammering. Okay, keep up the good work, guys.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Okay,
who's that?
And fisherman, they want to give a short update.
Yeah. Okay, good.
Okay, sorry again, but keep continuing.
Where were we?
Do you want your another coffee now? After all the breaks.
This will take a long time.
The other leg.
I just sent a text to all the participants. Break in, break in.
That's how it works. Yeah. We're talking about the fishy tackle stuff. We sell eight brands like Minn Kota, Hummingbird. We distribute those products as well in the Benelux.
Yeah.
Sorry. And we've been doing that for a long time already. And next to those two brands, Talon as well, one of the sponsors of the Predator Tour.
Yeah.
But Talon is a part of Minn Kota company,
mm-hmm.
and they all belong to the Johnson Outdoors company.
And
next to those products, we also distribute products like Rail Blazer.
Yeah.
It's all rod holders and for the belly boat and on the boat. And also for boating as well.
Mm-hmm.
Not fishing, but boating.
Boating, yeah.
And in addition to that, we sell products like Buff. We sell a lot of things.
Yeah, and it's all A brands.
All A brands.
And that's a real particular choice for
Technotic to only sell A brands?
Yeah, mainly A brands. Yeah, yeah. We want to deliver quality. We want to put nice products on your boat, yeah, so you can enjoy the quality of the, yeah, cooked products. Yeah. And we don't want to just fill a boat with products you don't
really need. You don't really like. No, I know what it is.
Yeah,
I know how it works.
Yeah.
But your first impression up about this form of the Predator 2. What do you think about the way it's been done this year? The COVID has made this really difficult to arrange. What's your first impression from? I know you've been online since this morning, 7:45. Mm-hmm. What's your first impression?
Before I answer the question, I would like to say that I'm very proud to be part of this.
Yeah, that's part of what I wanted to ask you.
Okay.
Okay, of course.
I know the COVID situation is bringing problems all over the world. Mm-hmm. And of course, we in the fishing business have also got the same problems.
Yeah.
But there's one thing you can, or there's actually a couple of things you can do when you want to organize a competition. And one thing is, okay, we're not allowed, so we don't do anything.
Mm-hmm.
And this is what I believe possible in this time.
Yeah, a creative solution. A
creative solution, yeah. Yes. Yeah. Yeah. And I think it's wonderful. Everybody can stream in, can show their fish,
yeah,
whatever they are
interaction.
Doing.
Yeah.
Interaction.
Yeah.
Avid is borrowing us all the time with people who come in. But this interaction, like,
yeah,
you say, yeah,
yeah,
I think,
yeah,
that's, yeah, it's really good.
And
really
do you,
nice,
think this might be a part of the future of fishing events like this competition, Predator 2?
For sure.
A combination, because we do not know how long this COVID thingy will go on.
Mm-hmm.
But do you think it will be a combination? I think it is, but you as a big sponsor for this kind of events?
Well, nobody knows when we go back to the normal situation.
Mm-hmm.
Normal, but eventually, when we do, I also think that this will become a part of our future.
Yeah.
That when we are able to organize a normal game,
mm-hmm,
so to say, we can also put this into the normal,
exactly,
situation,
exactly,
and go streaming, go live,
yeah,
put cameras on,
yeah,
board. People that want to watch this.
Yeah, like the American model.
Like the American model, yeah,
yeah.
Like a different type of fishing. For instance, when you go to Fishermania in England,
yeah,
you can see 24 hours, you can see the competition.
Yeah.
And to be honest, it's fishing with a pole. It's quite,
yeah,
boring to,
yeah,
see.
For us.
For us.
For us.
But this is, these boats are all over the place. And,
yeah,
they,
yeah,
they go there. They
more dynamics, more, yeah.
More dynamics.
Yeah, true.
Yeah.
True.
Last year,
what do you think about the real American? I've seen American models and events as well, and sometimes it's a bit too much for me. Or, and how about you?
We're Dutch.
We are.
They're American.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah. Almost everything they do, competition-wise, is too much for us.
Yeah.
But,
yeah,
and we don't want to copy the American way into Holland. We want to do it our own way.
We cannot do that.
And I think that Avid is well on his way to find his own way,
yeah,
to do this.
Yeah.
And when we go along, I'm sure we will find a format that
will
works
evolve
for everybody.
Yeah, it will evolve. I think so,
yeah,
too. Yeah. Cameras on board.
Good idea.
Good idea.
Yeah.
Do you think all people, all contestants would like to do that? Are they aware of the possibilities they might have to expose themselves or show the world the fishes or the brand they work for?
I'm not sure.
Too difficult question to answer.
No. I don't think it's too difficult, but I think it's this is like we said before, this is our future.
Yeah.
This is something we have to grow into. And I don't think that everybody is well aware of what the possibilities are.
Yeah.
But for instance, a couple of minutes ago, Bart van der Boom, one of our pro staffers who was on the water, who was,
yeah,
fishing the competition, he was live. And for me as a sponsor, as a co-worker of Technotic, he comes into, I think that's terrific.
But that's part of the American model as well.
That's part of the American model.
We still have to adapt to that, and we are Dutch and German and
we're European.
We are more like, okay, but I think that should be or is the future of what we are doing here. Why did you choose to be partner for exactly this? I know the answer, but I have to ask.
Well, you answer that.
What's in it for you? What's in it for you? What's really in it for you?
Well, it's hard to tell what's in it for us. The main thing is that when you want to spend a lot of money to sponsor a competition, you take a look at what's out there.
Yeah.
And you have to you want to make a choice because you cannot get involved in every competition that is going on, and you make a choice for the best competition you think is the best, and we think the Predator Tour that's been going on for 13 years, David, already 13 years
exactly.
It's growing, getting bigger. And we are proud to say that we've been on board for a couple of years already, and they're one of the premium sponsors. And we really believe in this concept, and we really believe that in this way we can show the participants, but also the people that are watching, in what way they are watching.
Even at work. We shall go working.
In the past on the YouTube channel, on Facebook, they see that we are involved, they see our products, they see our brands, and I think for a sponsor that's important, that you show that you're out there. And
when Ever had to decide to do it online, were you hesitant? Did you hesitate about still doing this, or were you with him directly?
It took about 2 seconds, I think.
Yeah.
I had a I had to let it sink in, and, but I think it's better to do something instead of nothing.
Yeah, and trust.
Yeah. Well,
That's it as well.
Yeah. When you go into a partnership, what this is a partnership.
Yeah, of course.
We cannot do this without him, and he cannot do this without us. So we have to work together. And when he comes with an idea, and in the beginning this was an idea, and he threw that at me, I said, okay, good idea. I had to let it sink in for a couple of seconds, but this is the alternative way.
Yeah.
And maybe the alternative way will become the future.
Yeah.
I'm sure it will become a part of the future.
Yeah.
But well, we'll have to wait and see.
Yeah.
Guys, can I interrupt the interview?
Sure.
As we speak, I sent out an open request for all the viewers. And Pieter Vrooman came in and has a question for you, Frans. His question is, do you think Hummingbird and Minn Kota can make a difference for the participants on the water? What is unique to the other brands don't have? Can you give Pieter an answer on that one, Frans?
Yeah, I will try. Well, first of all, I have to say that Pieter can answer the question himself because he's one of our dealers.
Okay. But I think he will ask that question because of for the viewers, of course.
Yeah, of course, I know. Thanks, Pieter. I will try to answer your question, do my best. First of all, I think that Hummingbird is well known for his side imaging. They have one of the most clear and beautiful pictures of whatever is out there. And Hummingbird works in a certain way. They bring into the market, they bring a couple of brands. One of them is Solex, the other one is Helix. And the Helix version is more preset.
Yeah,
and it's easy to operate and easy to use. And when you go into the Solex, you have more possibilities to do it the way you want it.
Yeah.
Sure, Pieter. Hummingbird can make the difference, but it's not as simple as putting a hummingbird on board and you can catch the whole world.
Yeah.
You have to try to learn how to work, how to get the best out of it. Yeah.
True.
That's what it is. And I think that's, I'm not going to say that hummingbird is the best you can get, because we all have our preferences. We all have the brands we like to work with, but hummingbird is one of the biggest brands. And
what do you think is the added value of hummingbird for a competition fisherman? Because it's easier, because I agree, you cannot say this is the best or this is the best, it's preferences. But
it's too simple.
In competition, time and fishing time is really important. Can hummingbird in combination with Minkauta make the difference in that?
Yeah, for sure.
Or is it a fisherman?
It's a combination of, but for sure you have to have a good basis, and the basis is why is Minkauta and hummingbird, why are they both part of the same company, Johnson Outdoors? Mm-hmm. It's not just two different companies, but they work together.
Yeah,
one of the biggest added values of Johnson Outdoor products is the One Boat Network.
Yeah.
You can connect your hummingbird to your Minkauta and to the Talon, to your outboard, and you can do everything on your hummingbird.
Yeah.
When you sit behind the wheel and you want to put your Talon
down,
if you want to drop your anchor,
you
push the button and your anchor goes down.
Yeah.
Do I need to say more?
No, you don't. But it's a really good question from Peter.
Yeah.
Frans, maybe it's not out in the open yet, but for me, as also a representative of the hummingbird Minkauta family, so to say, can you tell the audience something about the life? Is there any news? Because that's everybody wants to know. Is there a live version coming from hummingbird? Or you can't give any answers on that one yet?
No comments.
No comments, okay. Well, next question then.
The smile said it all. Yeah.
I didn't tell anything, I'm not gonna say anything. Again, no comment.
So it's not in
dangerous question.
Dangerous question, yes. Yeah, but it's a question, it's on everybody's lips.
I know, and I can understand. I can understand where it comes from, because we asked the same question also. But again, no comment.
Crystal clear. Okay, back to win.
Thanks to for win. This fantastic interruption.
Yes. You're welcome.
Want a coffee? I don't want to talk about Corona, because we've been discussing that, but this is a combination. Do you think Corona has affected or will affect fishing in general and event fishing for the future? And in what way?
Yeah, very difficult question.
Try to answer it, I'll get you some coffee.
Okay, thanks. Just leave me hanging here.
Yeah. Good luck.
Well, is COVID-19 going to infect the fishing tackle business? In a very broad way, I think, yeah. Supply chain has problems all over the world. Is it going to affect the fishing itself, competition wise, yeah, maybe. Maybe in the future we're not allowed to.
But I think it also makes people creative in a way. If the coronavirus didn't pop up, we didn't do this kind of information. So I think it makes also people, in a way, creative thinking, looking for new solutions to come up with new ideas, so to say.
Yeah.
So I don't think it all has to be a bad way. It has, in a way, it can trigger us to
watch over the horizon, I think.
Well, it's not all negative, and especially when you think about fishing itself.
That's wrong.
Yeah, during the last couple of months when we all had to stay home, there were a couple of things you were still allowed to do, and one of them is fishing. So what did we see? There were a lot of new fishermen born, so to say. Yeah. A lot of people said, well, I'm not allowed to go to a party, I'm not allowed to go to a festival.
Let's go whatever, fishing.
Let's go fishing.
Of course.
And maybe a big part of those newcomers will keep on fishing.
Yeah.
So
true.
We sold a lot of products last couple of months. And I'm in contact with a lot of colleagues, so to say, yeah. Also in the business. And they sold also good quantities.
Yeah.
So, is it negative? Is it all negative for fishing? No, I don't think so.
No, like if it says, it creates more creative possibilities.
Yeah. When you take a look at other disciplines within the fishing, maybe for freshwater fishing competitions, maybe you have more or smaller.
Yeah,
I don't know.
More and smaller.
More and smaller. Yeah.
True.
I don't know. We'll just have to wait and see, I think.
Yeah.
But this is a part of what is possible.
Yeah.
And when other people see that this is also a possibility to organize a bigger competition,
yeah.
Maybe it will grow into
a huge.
Yeah.
One.
Yeah.
Yeah. But if we can agree, this form in future might be a combination form, normal competition, but more live feeds. More viewers online and more exposure.
Yeah, if you see how much fun it is when everybody can see somebody
catching a fish,
why leave it out in the future? Why? If you want to organize a normal, so to say, competition and put this in, it even becomes bigger. Yeah,
yeah.
Well, it's better.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Well,
thanks for the coffee.
You're welcome. Anything else I can ask? Because I really don't want to talk about coffee anymore.
No, we've had enough of that, and we try to move on to something that is more positive.
But and in your company, that's all going well. You all can work from home or on the road.
Yeah, it's like we said before, it causes problems for everybody, for every company, and also for us. But we try to follow the rules. Since the last press conference from Mr. Rutte,
Thursday,
yeah,
Thursday,
2 weeks ago, 2.5 weeks ago, we decided to go back to working at home as
from
much
March,
as possible.
April period.
Yeah, so we've been working from home since March.
Yeah.
And a small intervention, so to say, when things got a little less. Yeah. But now we're back at where we started, and but it works for a lot of people. And I think also working from home, I think that a lot of companies have seen that it's possible.
Yeah, you and that they can trust people to work at home, and that's all doing well.
That too, but what we are doing now here, online streaming, we've done a lot of
online conferencing all over Europe,
and it works.
Yeah
instead of
I know
flying all over the place, you can just push the button and
I think a lot of offices will close down,
less
people, less square meters, just because we can do this.
Well,
let's fish more on big square meters.
Yeah.
Thank you for this.
You're very welcome.
If you have
thank you too.
Anything to add, please say so. Nice.
Well, I will enjoy the rest of the day here, and hope that a lot of interruptions will come again.
I hope so too.
I can promise you that I will interrupt you constantly.
Okay. I'll depend on that. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay, Frans, from my side here, it was very nice to have you in our studio as our premium partners for Minn Kota, Technolic and Hummingbird. Also important to know that Minn Kota and Hummingbird are the premium sponsor and the unique sponsor of our free to download, because all the costs are already paid by Minn Kota and Hummingbird, so it's free to download. the credit to web app, you can see also the live leaderboard and so on.
It works, of course,
yeah, and it's sponsored, like I said, by Minn Kota and Hummingbird, the company from France, but also from Sweden. We have a close partnership for the Swedish event with Comstedt, and also Johnson Outdoors. It's all connected as one big happy family. So again, Frans, Wim already said it, I will say it again, very nice to have you here in our live studio.
Nice to be here.
It's a yeah, long ride for you, as I know, and you take the time and effort to visit us, and I will thank you for that. Any last words to the viewers, the participants?
Well, there's just a few words to say to all the participants. I wish everybody all the best and tight lines for the next couple of days. And be prepared for the future and keep on hammering.
Okay, well, talking about the future, I will put in the short movie of the Minn Kota Raptor. And it's also represented by the Minn Kota Hummingbird and Johnson Outdoor, and as a dealer of Technologic. Well, Frans, from here and now, thanks for watching, and I hope to see you soon again.
When you find fish, you need to stay on fish. That's why we built Raptor. It doesn't just stop your boat, it never stops stopping. Raptor relentlessly keeps you on fish by anchoring in securely, then keeping you there automatically. With active anchoring, Raptor senses when wind, waves, or current threaten to push you off your spot. Then it fights back by doubling down, re-anchoring automatically, and securing you until you're ready to move. That's how Raptor keeps you locked in. But the perfect hold starts with another intelligent feature. Auto bottom mode detects what you're anchoring into and adjusts the force accordingly, so you get enough power to dig into rocks without getting stuck in mud or silt. And when it's time to move, just press a button to pull Raptor back up. We packed it with more anchor retraction force to get you out of anything and onto your next spot easily. It's the only anchor that starts strong, stays strong, and doesn't leave until you're good and ready. And that reliability is backed by Raptor's rock-solid construction and extruded aluminum brackets. Every inch, every hinge, and every component is tested rigorously and built with legendary Minn Kota toughness, so it'll take a beating and come back for more, year after year. Raptor is controllable from anywhere. It comes with a wireless remote and has an available wireless foot switch. Plus, it's part of the One Boat network, which means you can raise and lower it directly from your Hummingbird fish finder, an iPilot remote, or the Raptor mobile app. No matter where you are on your boat when you find your spot, you're always one touch of a button away from being able to anchor in with Raptor. And once you do, Raptor won't quit until you get what you came for. It senses the bottom, the wind, the waves, and anything else that threatens your ability to stay on fish. Then it hits back to keep you on your spot all day long. Because Raptor is relentless. And it's only from Minn Kota.